The bloodstream is an extremely dramatic place. It links all your organs together, provides nutrients, proteins, and oxygen. About 60% of the 5 liters of blood in your body is a fluid called plasma. The rest is cells. And it's all moving at 3 to 4 miles per hour. These cells transform into fierce warriors whenever an invader is detected. Introducing your body's supporters and defenders, the cells of the blood. Our journey begins in the bone marrow, the spongy tissue inside our bones where the blood cells are born. They escape through little vessels that connect the bones to the rest of the bloodstream. There are 3 main types of cells in the blood, each with a specialized role: platelets, red blood cells, and white blood cells. Let's take a closer look. First up, we have platelets, tiny little helpers that flow through the bloodstream, not doing a whole lot. But when a vessel gets damaged, either from a chemical imbalance in the surrounding area or from physical damage like a cut, platelets get a signal that it's their time to shine. They rush to the site of damage and stick together, extending little tentacles to patch up any holes in the vessel, forming a clot and stopping more damage. Next up are red blood cells, also called erythrocytes. They're the most abundant blood cell. In every cubic millimeter of blood, you can find around 5 million red blood cells. Their job is to pick up oxygen from the lungs, store it in little red packages called hemoglobin that make the blood red. Then, they truck it to the rest of the body so your organs can use it to make energy from sugar and fat. They're so dedicated to this job that they don't even have nuclei. Their dented hockey puck shape makes more room for hemoglobin. After they drop off their oxygen, they have to return to the lungs to grab more and start the process all over again. The most complicated cells of the blood are the white blood cells, aka leukocytes, an important part of the body's immune system. They're a squadron of elite agents that identify and hunt down threats to the body, like viruses and bacteria. They can be divided by their specialized roles. Some cells notice when something's off and sound the alarm. Others are in charge of directly fighting the threat. These cells can recognize, remember, and hunt down virus-infected cells, mutated tumor cells, you name it. And those are the cells of the blood.